EP120, Chapter 1, Topics, Introduction to the 11 Body Systems. So, here is the organism, and the human organism has been broken down into 11 different organ systems, or you can also call them body systems. The first up is this organ system. You should recognize it as the skeletal system. That's right, the skeletal system. Its components includes the various bones that makes up the skeleton, the ligaments that holds the bones to each other, and the joints, the places where the bones are adjacent to each other, and sometimes they can move there at the joint, and sometimes they can't. Functions of the skeletal system. Well, protection of delicate organs, such as the brain in the skull, the heart and lungs, and the thoracic cage. A framework giving our body its overall shape. Attachment site for muscles, which then can allow for movement. Blood cell production in the red bone marrow. And mineral storage, especially calcium. Then we have this organ system. This is known as the muscular system. The muscular system made up of the various muscles. Muscles, most of which attach to bones and are able to allow for movement at joints, and the muscles are attached to those bones by tendons. Functions of this muscular system include movement, allowing us to move our body, posture, so we can uphold that upright position even without thinking about it, and thermoregulation, or body temperature. Contractions of these skeletal muscles generate heat to help maintain our body temperature. Then we have this lovely system known as the nervous system. Nervous system includes the brain, the spinal cord, the nerves coming off the brain and spinal cord, and the sense organs such as the eyes, the tongue, the ears, and so on. Functions of the nervous system include receiving information via receptors, sending that information to the brain and spinal cord via the nerves, interpreting the information, often involving comparing that information to a set point, and then responding to the information, sending commands via the nerves to the effectors to cause a response. And therefore, the nervous system is involved in controlling many activities of the body. Then we have this lovely system. What do we see here? It's the integumentary system. Integumentary system includes the skin, which is our largest organ, the subcutaneous layer directly below the skin, and the hair and nails. Functions of the integumentary system include protecting underlying structures, protecting from abrasions, protecting from impacts, protecting from chemicals, from sun exposure, and so on. Thermal regulation, the skin can help to regulate our body temperature by sweating or not sweating, by increasing blood flow to the skin or decreasing blood flow. And also the skin houses many sensory receptors. The skin is a very sensuous organ. Then we have this lovely system, slightly different between males and females. This system is the endocrine system. Endocrine system includes a hodgepodge of various glands and organs, such as the pituitary gland in the underneath the brain, the thyroid gland in the throat region, the pancreas in the abdominal cavity, the testes or ovaries, depending on which you have, and additional other components, all doing one thing, and that is secreting hormones. So what connects all of these structures is the fact that they produce and release hormones. And these hormones are important for controlling activities in the body. That's right. Then we have this lovely system here called the cardiovascular system. Cardiovascular system includes the heart, the blood vessels, which can be broken down into arteries and veins, and of course, the blood found within the blood vessels. The important function of the cardiovascular system is to transport substances throughout the body. So it is transportation, moving things throughout the body, including water, ions, nutrients, wastes, hormones, heat. heat, lots of things being transported throughout the body. Then we have this lovely system here, known as the lymphatic system. Lymphatic system includes components such as lymph vessels, shown in green lines here, lymph nodes, the little circles attached to those green lines, the spleen here in purple, the tonsils, which you can't see in this picture. The lymphatic system has a few important functions. These include transporting excess fluids, taking excess fluids in our tissues and returning it to the cardiovascular system, returning it to the bloodstream. Also involved in transporting dietary fatty substances, fats that we absorb. And very importantly, it is also key for the defending against infections. So important for our immune response. Then we have this system here, known as the digestive system. Digestive system has many components, including the mouth and oral cavity, the esophagus, the stomach, the small intestine, the large intestine, the liver, the gallbladder, the pancreas, salivary glands, lots of components to the digestive system. Its functions include breaking down food, aka digestion, making the food smaller, as well as breaking down the large macromolecules into smaller molecules we can absorb. Brings us to the second function, absorbing those nutrients, passing them through the walls of the intestines into the bloodstream. And then finally, eliminating undigested waste products via defecation. We have this lovely system, the respiratory system, including such components as the nasal cavity, the larynx, the trachea, and the lungs. The respiratory system is involved in moving air into and out of the lungs. And the reason we do this is to allow for gas exchange, to allow for oxygen to move from the air into our bloodstream, and to allow carbon dioxide to move from the bloodstream into the air we then exhale. Then we have this deceptively simple system here, known as the urinary system. Urinary system includes two kidneys, two ureters that connect to the urinary bladder, and then the urethra. Note urinary bladder, two words. If you write down bladder as an answer to a question, it will be counted as wrong. It is urinary bladder. Functions of the urinary system includes removing wastes from the blood, regulation of proper blood composition, and regulation also of the blood's pH. And then, of course, storing those wastes in the form of urine in the urinary bladder and then eliminating the urine through the urethra. And then we have this body system, which is very different between male and females. The reproductive system. So in males, we have the testes, the prostate, the urethra, and the penis. And the main functions of the male reproductive system is to produce and transport sperm. That's it. Then we have the female reproductive system. Female reproductive system includes such structures as the ovaries, the uterine tubes, the uterus, vagina, vulva. It's worth noting here that the uterine tubes used to be called fallopian tubes. Not anymore. Do not use that term. It is uterine tubes, tubes attaching to the uterus. And the functions of the female reproductive system includes production and maintenance of the oocytes, also known as egg cells, coming from the ovaries, supporting the development of the fetus within the uterus, and of course, childbirth to expel the infant when the developing process is complete. As if for this part of